Central Michigan versus JMU. JMU took the first point in the first half. We went to halftime. Central Michigan came back out in the second half, took care of business. About 14 minutes left, so we will see how the rest of this game goes down. If either team is able to score a point before the end of regulation, or if we will be headed for overtime. Left. swing the momentum back in their favor with 9:02 left in the second half. Timeout. JMU is definitely dominating this point.
JMU, according to our JMU is dominating. So we'll take a quick break.
Three for JMU going down there. That is 13 Dukes left on the court. Looks like 10 left. It's intentional. JMU looks like they lost. Yes, losing Sizemore, number 92. So now a 12-10 advantage man-wise for the JMU Dukes. Sounds like Joey Cardella had a catch. Bring one of the JMU players back in, so they now have 13 players on the floor. We have 7 minutes left. 7 minutes left in this second half. Shot to the front door. Foot there, takes out number four. And a catch falling away over here in the corner right beneath us by 00 Gromer. Thank you. 13 in for JMU. And 7 out. Yeah, so 8 in for Central Michigan. Michigan needs to hold out another 3 minutes and 30 seconds to send this game into overtime. Seven Chippewas left on the court to 14 for JMU. The advantage that CMU has right now is that they have all but one of the balls. That one being the one they just threw. So total ball advantage right now, CMU. JMU with a 2-1 man advantage, 14-7. And number 3 goes down there for JMU on an attempted catch. Left in this half. It is very likely to be headed for overtime. 37 for JMU, eliminating number 21 there for Central Michigan. The Chippewas on a 10-second shot clock with 1:30 left in this game. Left, 20 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. And this game will head to overtime. 6-6 to decide who gets a chance to play Grand Valley State University in the NCAA championship.